my little cozy lair. Welcome to Trigger Point Pilates, yoga and balls. And I'm outside today, really outside. The weather is gorgeous in Orlando right now. The humidity's gone. There's a little breeze in the air. This is where Floridians get excited and they get out their boots and their fall clothes because excitement. We may have a couple of days of a little crispness and coolness. So I'm outside. Today we'll be focusing on releasing the myofascia, especially getting into releasing your calf muscles. Last week I was really suffering with mine and I had a little play with my foam roller and my balls and some yoga stretches and it helped me so much. So today you'll just need your foam roller, two prickle balls and a small towel. Alright, so let's start on the foam roller just because it's really lovely to realign the spine and just relax and get into that little groove of the parasympathetic system taking over and giving you some TLC. Alright, okay my darlings. So, as always, come and sit with your bum supported and your head too. If you need extra support for your neck just to align your cervical spine, feel free to put a towel underneath your head. Bend your knees, keep your feet hips width apart. I like to go a bit wider, it just feels good for me. Close your eyes, I'll be as descriptive as I can so that you don't have to keep turning and looking at your screen. You can just listen to my voice. All right, my loves. And just rest your arms by your side. Focus in on your breathing. Let's take a deep breath together. So breathe in deeply through your nose. Sigh that air out. Do that again. Deep breath in. Sigh it out. And then just breathe naturally in and out through your nose if you can. See if you can make your inhales equal to your exhales. And don't be afraid to move around. If you feel you want to adjust yourself on your foam roller, just like I'm doing, go ahead and do that. Move your feet around, have a little sway. Feel what's going on in your back this afternoon or today, whatever time you're doing this class. Good, and then bring your hips to center. And let's do those circles with the arms. You can start small. I'm going big. I'm really going for it right away because I took class today and I'm feeling it already, friends. So it's time to get those kinks out. So you do you. And make this motion as large or small as you like. And remember to focus on your breathing. So steady breath. Do you ever look up the sky at the aeroplanes and wonder where they're going? I do. I'd love to be on an aeroplane going somewhere delicious. Alright, and then take your circles the other way. Let your scapula really work around that foam roller, yes? To release there. Have some give in your back. Avoid holding yourself rigid. And then rest your arms down. Breathe out, lift one leg up, hold on behind that thigh if you can with same hand as leg. Pull that leg towards you, let your back elongate. Feel your chin pull to your chest. Don't worry if the other knee wants to point out to the side, let that happen. It's okay, that's just your hips realigning, adjusting. Let go of that leg and lower your foot down. Other leg, exhale, lift. Hold on, pull it towards you. Breathe. And what I call the pull-throughs. So pull your feet in a bit closer to you. Deep breath in, reach your arms up and over your head. Let your chest open and exhale. Push your heels down, tilt your pelvis, pull your arms towards your thighs. Feel your back elongate. Breathe in, let that lumbar spine lift. Let it go, open heart. Exhale, pull through. Keep going at your own pace. Maybe you would like to lift your head and shoulders off the roller as you pull through. This personal choice. You can keep your head down if that feels better today. Let's do one more round. Oh, that breeze is so lovely. Good. And then just take your feet out wider. Have a little rock from side to side. Let's do a leg slide, just to lengthen out that hip flexor. Let's slide one leg long, give it a little shake out there. Flex your foot, you could reach one or both arms overhead. Drop your rib cage, drop your abs, stretch, breathe in. And exhale, pull your arms down, draw your heel back in. Other leg, slide it long, give it a shake. Relax that hip joint, flex your foot, reach one or both arms overhead, drop your rib cage, stretch, breathe, and exhale, come back to your starting position. Alright lovelies, gently sway and come off of your foam roller, pop it to one side, and find your prickables. Needles. I'm right under a pine tree. I can feel them falling on me as I sit here. Alright, so bend your knees, put your feet flat on the floor, and place your balls under each of your glutes. Yes? Your choice whether they're in closer or out a little bit wider. Use your hands, your arms like kickstands. Lift your head out of your neck. So avoid collapsing down. So think open chest, long neck, and gently. Oh, butterfly, did you see that? I hope she flew towards the camera so you could see. Rocking forwards and back. Avoid going side to side. Sometimes I watch people in class and they want to go side to side, but stick to going forwards and back. The reason being, if you have any sensitivity around that sciatic nerve, the side to side movements are not incredibly beneficial. All right, so forward or back will really help you. Always take the balls out wider if you need to adjust and get a different area. Oh, this is like one of my favorite moves, friends. I could do this all day long, especially after a bar class. All that glute squeezing. All right, we can't be here all day. We have to carry on, Sarah. All right, so come and sit up. The balls will come down lower, so the base of your glutes, the top of your hamstrings, your choice what you do with your legs. Yes, mine are in a narrow V. You could go out wider, you could have them closer, you could bend them out to the side and keep your feet pointed. Play with it, yeah? You can do several different things while you're here. Switch it up, see what you like. Every day's different, right? Keep your feet pointed for now. Sit up tall, breathe in, and exhale, gently flow forward. Now remember, it's not a competition as to how far we can go, my lovelies. Breathe in, reach up. You're feeling. Exhale, fall forward. What's going on? Does one side feel different to the other? Yeah? My left side is tighter than my right side today. Yeah? I definitely feel it on the left side more than the right. If you do not have any issues with your sciatic nerve, you can flex your feet and alternate between pointing and flexing. If you do have sensitivity there, then keep your feet pointed. It will feel more pleasant for you. And just moving with your breath, like a wave. And if you do have the urge just to hang out there for a little bit and relax into it, I like to sway a little bit
it from side to side. You can do that. Lovely. And then come to center, slowly roll up. Take the balls away. And let's release the calf muscles now. So, stretch one leg out, okay? One of your balls will go, see that crook behind your knee? Just above it, so at the base of your hamstring. And then the second ball will go somewhere on your calf muscle. Now, depending on what you've been up to, that will depend on where you want the ball. So feel free to start low and work up, or vice versa, and have a feel as to where you need that release, okay? This leg is just hanging out for the ride, so you do what you like with it, and just massage side to side. And already you can probably feel, that lower ball, I want to have it lower, have it up higher. I seem to have mine in the right position, so yay. And then you can turn that leg in and out and in and out. Yeah. Find stillness. Go ahead and take that ball low, so it's right behind your Achilles. Okay, let it hang out there for a second. And you can point or flex or floint your foot, whichever feels best for you. And then depending on your body type, yeah, it really just depends on how tall you are, how long your arms are, your strength, etc. You've got some choices. So you can press down into this quad with both hands, with one hand, opposite hand. Figure out what feels comfortable for you. So this works comfortable for me. So breathe in, you're releasing. Exhale, press down into that thigh. Breathe in, release. Exhale, push. Good. Bring that ball up to the middle part of your calf muscle. Breathe in, sit up. Exhale, press down. Breathe in, release. Exhale, push. And then bring that ball up higher still. So never actually behind the knee, just below that little crease there at the back. Breathe in, release. Exhale, push. One more time. Breathe in, release. Exhale, push. Excellent. Take the balls away. Compare legs. Whew. It's quite remarkable, isn't it? This leg feels longer, looser, lighter than the other one. I love these balls. I hope you do too. All right, let's do the other leg. All right, so one ball above the crook of the knee at the base of the hamstring, and then place that second guy wherever you want on your calf muscle. Just have a little rock and a sway to start off with. My left side is very tight at the moment. All down from my neck, down here, yeah. So I'm really thrilled to be here working the kinks out with you guys. And turn the leg in and out and in and out. Beautiful. Lower that bottom ball down behind your Achilles, behind your ankle. Yeah. Sit up tall, breathe in. And exhale, push down. Breathe in, release. Exhale, push. Good. Bring the ball up to the middle part of your calf muscle. Breathe in, release. Exhale, push. Breathe in. Exhale. And then pull that ball up higher. Breathe in, sit up. Exhale, push. Once more, breathe in. Exhale, push. it's a bit more even, isn't it? All right, my lovelies, put your balls to one side. Not too far away, because you'll need them again in a little bit. All right, let's just do some gentle yoga stretches to release and lengthen out the calf muscles. So come and meet me on all fours in a tabletop position. Place your hands underneath your shoulders. Spread your fingers out wide and turn your index fingers to face directly forwards. Keep your knees hips width apart. Curl your toes under and lift your hips up towards the ceiling. Yes, you're coming into that downward dog position. Now pull your shoulders actively down your back and open your triceps out and away from each other. Yeah, so you should feel that you have lots of length in your neck. And give your head a little shake. Say yes and no, and all around. There we go. Good. Now claw your hands so that you have a little bit of space underneath the palm, yes? So that your fingers are active as well. This is going to protect your wrists and your hands. And then walk your dog. So bend one knee. Really push that straight leg, that heel down into the floor. And switch it. Oh, lovely. And just keep moving, yes? Keep your neck long. Avoid those shoulders popping up towards your ears. And keep reaching long through your tailbone. So you're going to get that stretch in your gastroc and your soleus, your calf muscles. You're also getting a stretch in your back, in your hamstrings, and your glutes too. Let's do one more bend on each side. Good. Now bring your left foot in a little bit closer and take your right foot, spread your big toe and your second toe away from each other and place them around the heel of your left foot and then push down using your toes onto that left heel. Keep reaching your tailbone up towards the ceiling. Pull your abs in. Ooh, so you're getting a really good stretch. Can you feel it right in the top of your calf muscle? It gets right up behind your knee. So nice deep breaths, breathing in and exhaling out. Breathe in and out. Once more, breathe in and out. Good. Okay, pedal those feet out a little bit. Press both heels towards the floor. Bring your right foot in a bit closer. Lift your left foot off the floor. Spread out your big toe and your second toe and hook it behind your right heel and then press down. Okay, start gentle. Keep your neck long. Keep wrapping those triceps out and around. Breathing in. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Beautiful. Come back to your downward facing dog. Pedal those knees. Walk your dog. Good. Do you feel like the back of your legs are getting longer? I feel like my heels are coming closer to the ground. I hope yours do too. Good. And then just come down onto your knees. Find your towels, my friends. I just got a little one. Just take it. You can roll it up like this. And then just place it between your calf muscles and your hamstrings. Yeah? Have your toes relaxed to start off with. So Vrajasana. Sit up nice and tall. Pull your shoulders back and down. Hopefully you feel that little bit of compression. impression with the towel there. Yes, right in the middle of your calf muscle. Always feel free to use like a soft cushion or pillow if you prefer that. Another breath. And then just place your hands on the floor. Curl your toes under. And again, sit back on your heels. So feel what's happening now. Yes, you are going to stretch out the arches of your feet too. Get a deeper stretch in your quads as well. Lift up nice and tall. Breathe in. Drop your shoulders as you exhale. Release your toes, take that towel out, pop it to one side, come and sit down on your bottoms, extend your legs forward, flex your feet. Now, actually, you could have your towel handy for this if you wanted to. So have it so that it's rolled up long ways, and you could always place that towel right underneath the arches of your feet. Sit up tall first. Flex your feet. Have some space between your legs. It'll make your hips happy. Sit up tall. And then as you exhale, start to walk your hands forward. Now, this may be enough for you. Fight for straight legs here so that you can effectively stretch out from the Achilles up the calf muscles, the hamstrings, the low back, and the glutes. All right? If you'd like to use your towel here, you can. Keep that spine long. Actively pull your shoulders down your back. And take your time here. There's no rush. Breathing in, lengthen. Exhale, move deeper. Breathe in. And exhale. Really surrender to it. Breathe in. Exhale. You want to take a hold of your toes or the outer edges of your feet, feel free. Let's do three more breaths here. So breathe in, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Breathe in, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Breathe in, lengthen. Exhale, surrender. Good. And then just point your toes, relax your hands down, round your back, slowly coming on up. All right, my darling, come and bring your legs behind you. Pop your towel to one side. To all fours again, spread your fingers out wide, keep your legs hips width apart, slide your left leg back and press the ball of your foot down into the ground, so really push, and you can keep your elbows slightly soft if that feels good for you, get length in your neck, really press down through that heel, breathe in, exhale, push. Your left foot back there. Press down with your hands firmly. Now lift your right knee up off the floor. Bring your nose to your knee. Now push back with that left heel. Push back. Use your hands here to help you. Push, push, push. Breathe in. Exhale, press more. Keep your back rounded. Breathe in. Exhale. See if you can kiss your kneecaps. Breathe in. Push that left heel down. Exhale. Good. Carefully lower your right knee down. bring your left knee back so you're coming back to that tabletop position. Feel free to have a little circular movement with your hips. If you need to come up and release your wrists, be my guest. I know it can get a bit much, right? All those downward dogs and planks. Back we come and slide your right foot back. Stretch more. Good. Press down with your hands. Go ahead and lift that left knee up. Bring your nose to your knee, or your knee to your nose. Breathe in. Exhale. Press that right heel towards the floor. Ooh, use your hands here to help you. Breathe in. Exhale. One more time. Breathe in. Exhale. Lovely. Slowly lower back down, coming back to all fours. Have a little roll if you need to. Shake out your wrists. Gorgeous. You'll need your towel again, my lovelies. This time, hold it. So it's kind of in three, if you like. Yeah? Have it handy. Sunday, coming up, bend your knees a lot and take the towel and place it underneath your toes. So your heels are on your mat, but your toes and the pads of your feet are on the towel. And you can always work up to having a bigger towel or a cushion underneath your toes. Alright, but for now, start small. Keep your legs hips width apart, bend your knees a lot, let your body hang down, just let go with your back, yeah? Have a little sway. Good. And then, if you can, start to lengthen your legs. Right? You might need to come up a little bit higher. You can always have yoga blocks and put your hands down on them if that feels better for you. And shift your weight forwards. Yes, so avoid sitting back into your hips. Shift your weight forwards over the pads of your feet. It makes it more doable. It keeps your hamstrings protected, gives you the most effective stretch. Let your head hang heavy. Breathe in. Exhale. Feel free to hold on to opposite elbows like I'm doing, if that works for you. Breathe in. Exhale. One more time. Breathe in. Exhale. Lovely. Soften your knees. Put your hands down. Just put that towel to one side. Go ahead and step forward with your right foot, back with your left. Come into a pyramid position. Be sure that your legs are hips width apart. Pull your right hip back and your left hip forward. Yep. Keep your weight. Adjust your weight. So play with it. Sort of rock forwards and back and feel. Again. If you need yoga blocks so you can come up higher and make this more doable for you, please, please help yourselves. Now inhale, lengthen your spine. Exhale, fold forwards. If you'd like to deepen the stretch, lift your front toes up off the floor. You can pull on the bottom of your right foot with your hand. You could also take your towel and pop it under there. Yes? Like a little wedge to deepen that stretch all up the back of your right calf muscle behind your hamstring, your glutes. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, fold. Good. Carefully take that towel out. Bring your feet side by side. Have a little bend of the knees. Shake your booty around. Good. And then we'll switch legs. leg, so step forward with your left foot and whoops, don't fall over, Sarah. So elegant. And back with your right. Good. Shift your weight forward and back. Feel. Yeah? Feel what feels nice. Pull your left hip back, right hip forward. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, fold.
Oh, yes, this side.
It's this side for me, friends, today.
Good.
Now, lift those front toes up. You can use your hand, or you can pop your tail there. Let that flex foot just lengthens out that gastroc and soleus even more. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Try to keep your neck long. Breathe in. Exhale. Once more. Inhale. And exhale. Fabulous. Carefully, carefully take that towel away. Bring your feet side by side. Bend your knees. Pedal out your feet. Keep your knees very soft. Yeah, bend them. I got them really bent a lot. You do you, okay?
Get your head high.
You are slowly coming up. Take your time, my lovelies. We've been upside down for a while. Avoid getting the dizzies, okay? So slowly, slowly. Slowly, slowly, up you come.
Oh, goodness.
Ooh, maybe give those arms a big roll out. Ah, oh, that was good. Oh, let's do that again. That feels yummy. Ah, wonderful. All that's left is a little massage for our feet. If you need to hold on to something, you can take your foam roller and hold on to that. I'm going to lift dangerously and see if I can balance after all that relaxing. All right, so press down on the ball. Give your tootsies a massage. You got socks on, take them off, my lovelies. Trust me, your feet will thank you for it. And make sure that you get everywhere. Your heels, the middle of your foot, the pads, toesies, outer edge, inner edge, push down, release, compare. So light on this side. All right, other foot, rub a dub dub. Lovely. All the bits. Bobs, push down. Good. All right. Face me. Put your feet hips width. Breathe in. Reach up. Exhale. Blow that air out. Again. Breathe in. Reach up. Exhale. All right, my darlings. That's it for today. I hope that helped you. That's something that you can always come back to if you've been working out or you've been hiking up a mountain and your calf muscles are really tight and sore. Pull up this practice again and I think it will help to loosen things up. So thank you for joining me and I'll see you again soon. Farewell.